Well, that was a nice win for our team. I thought our defense was excellent. Oregon State is very good offensively with our starting lineup, and they can all score. So to hold this team to 59 points was a credit to our players who played very hard and limited our mistakes.
Talk about Stewart tonight. He had obviously shooting all
he shot the ball great. I think he's going to leave here as the all-time three-point shot. Field goal makes, I think, the school record. I don't know if he set it yet or not. Does anyone know? It's close.
He's one off.
He's one off?
Yeah.
Okay, well, hopefully he'll set it next game. So when you got a guy that can shoot the ball like that, he's just been, he really played well against Oregon the other night. He played well. He had a tough road trip when we lost to Arizona State in Arizona. He didn't play very well. And I was very, we've all been very proud of him coming back here. This homestand helped us win two games.
What allowed for him to shoot the ball that well tonight?
Well, he's a very good shooter, but you know, whenever you have a point guard like Jordan, I always joked it. Be nice. I would like to play on this team. All you got to do is stand on the three-point line, wait for the ball to come, and knock down some shots because you're wide open. Because when you got a point guard like Jordan McLaughlin on your team, he gets guys with wide open shots and then when you have Chemezi either posting up or rolling to the rim, the defense has to focus on him. But Stewart's a tremendous shooter, and he is obviously a confident player. He had 28 points. And I think he only missed one shot, 5 for 5 from the 3, 9 for 10 from the field.
Coach, congrats on the win tonight. What made this stretch, home stretch, different from other games when the team has struggled to defend this league?
I'm sorry, sir.
Why was the team so able to defend off Oregon State in those final minutes when we've seen them falter?
Well, this was a grinded out every possession game. They play very hard. They're physical and they're very talented. They're a good team. They have some big wins this year in the league, and we just had to keep playing for 40 minutes. I thought our players gave effort the entire time. We made a couple defensive mistakes early in the first half. We had a 6-point lead, and we let Emmanuel hit 2 threes. That was our fault. And then in the second half, our goal was just to challenge as much as we could and hold them. I think they only had 23 shot attempts in the second half.
Coach, now that you know that Benny's out for the rest of the season, what are the biggest adjustments you guys will be making?
Well, it's very devastating for Benny and for our program. We've had the Anthony Melton all season. Now you lose a guy that was our leading scorer last year, second leading scorer, second leading rebounder. So you start taking 40% of your starting lineup out. But we're very proud of our other players. That's why you have a program and a team. You need other players to step up, and they're very capable of doing that. We just have to play very, very hard. And we don't have to play perfect, but we have to play very hard the rest of the season.
It's really important to protect home court. How satisfying is it that your guys did that this week?
Yeah, it's so hard to win on the road. This is as deep a Pac-12 conference as I've seen. Maybe 2 years ago it was as deep as well, but like Oregon State, you go up to Oregon State, it's hard to win there. And every team in this league, or most teams, it's a toss-up. You can win or lose every game, and a lot of close games this year, and we have a lot of teams that our top 100 in the RPI, and a lot of teams deserve to be in an NCAA tournament selection conversation. A lot of teams in our league are beating up on each other. And I think you've seen the league records reflect that. So we're fortunate to hold home court. You have to try to win as many games you can at home because the road is so hard. Unfortunately, we've lost 3 buzzer beaters on the road. And I think, what are we now, 7-1 at home.
Did you by chance look up at the scoreboard when they flashed the UCLA and Oregon?
I did not. I heard UCLA won in overtime, so it's a good win for them. Oregon's a really good team, and so is UCLA, so I'm sure it was a great game. It was an overtime game.
Do these games at home feel like you have to win, must-win games at home? Because a home loss always looks bad at the end.
Well, I think you just have to try to win as many games you can, take it game by game. And when we're 7-1 at home, we lost our first one, so we've won 7 in a row. So obviously that's been huge for the success up to this point. But we have 3 games left, and we're just going to focus on our next game, which is Wednesday night.
Jordan Usher played a lot tonight. We know he's a solid defender. Can you talk about his offensive abilities?
Oh, he's a very good passer. Very, very high energy. Puts the ball down the floor. He goes hard. He's hard to guard. because he goes so hard, and he's such a big body kid, and he's a very good passer off the move. So I thought he played really well tonight, gave us great energy, and we're going to need him to play more at the power forward position with Boatwright out.
Coach, has Benny had an MRI? Do you know exactly what?
Yes, he did. Yeah, it's not an ACL, which is thankfully. And his MCL is a little stretched, but it was the patella, the ligament of the patella. So there's no surgery required. Now, this is the word I'm getting, and I'm certainly no doctor, so if that changes tomorrow, please forgive me. But as of now, it's a recovery period similar to what he had last year with the MCL. You have to let it heal, and once the swelling goes down here in the next 2 weeks, then you can start to do whatever kind of therapy they prescribe.
Is there any reason why Benny and
D'Anthony
worked for the team on the bench tonight?
What's that?
D'Anthony has been
promoted
to the
team. I didn't even see that, so honestly, I have no idea. They weren't out on the bench at all?
No.
Okay.
He had good success against the Oregon team this year. It's the first time we swept them.
First time we have, yes. When you go on the Oregon State trip, that's a really tough road trip because both those teams are so good at home, and we were fortunate to win a close game, two close games on the road, and then a buzzer beater on Thursday night. So that's 4-0 against the Oregon teams. That's big, especially if you want to go to where we want to go, and we have a lot of work to do.
Anything else for Coach?
Coach, you guys have lost a lot of close games this year. Is getting over the hump and winning those games something that just needs to happen, or is there something you communicate to your guys to help them get there?
Well, we lost games because we didn't make shots and we didn't get stops. It's pretty simple. Like Oregon the other night, we made a play. We beat Oregon on the road. We were down in the last 2 minutes of Oregon on the road and came back and made plays down the stretch. Stanford, we made a play that we thought we won. The guy hit a 55-foot shot. So we made the play to win the game, and then they made a 55-footer. The UCLA game was tied. We made a defensive mistake with 50 seconds left, and Thomas Welsh hit a three. We were right there, and then we still had a chance to take the lead, and we didn't execute, and then we had a chance to tie. So the margin of error is so small. Arizona State, we had three turnovers in the last 3 minutes of the game, and then we had still a tie game, and Chemezi missed a layup. So when you say over the hump, well, your leading scorer shoots a layup with 30 seconds left in the game, you feel pretty good, especially when he's 6'11". And they come down, they make a shot with 1 second left. So those five games, we won two of them and lost three, and unfortunately we had some bad luck in those games we've lost, but that's part of basketball. It's part of sports. You have to make plays down the stretch, and we love our players, and it's okay. They missed a couple shots. They challenged some shots. The other team made some tough ones, and that's what it is. You know, you can't dwell on that. You have to go back and play and fight harder and get better. And so, we have a veteran team. It's not because they haven't been in those situations. Shoot, the SMU game last year, it was a 1-point game in the NCAA tournament. They won that one. The Providence game, we were down 17 at halftime or 15 at halftime. They came back and won that one. So they won two games in the NCAA tournament last year. Baylor, we were up 4 with 6 minutes left and had a chance to win, and they took the lead and they made plays. So our players have been in a lot of big games. You just have to try to do your best. And we're very proud of them from what they've accomplished. We have 19 wins right now. We're tied for second in the Pac-12. And we're going to go focus Wednesday night and try to do our best on the road.